Hopefully you all can hear me. I am playing Firewatch, and I hear myself. I'm just trying to make sure the frame rate is fine as I play with this. And I hear myself through the chat, so I'm going to mute this. I'm just messing around a little bit in X. I'm using the headset. Hopefully, they are not still asleep. Let me know if that works.
know if that works.
Was that a burn, you ask? She says, definitely. Where did you hurt your feelings? She asks if you want to split a cheeseburger. A week later, you're Julia's boyfriend. Hey, Bunny. Thanks for the host. Oh, hey.
Hey, buddy. Thanks for the host.
Hang on 1 second. I'm just trying to mute myself on this on my other monitor. Hang on.
Oh, hey.
I am actually using a controller. Huh. Must be a short stream if I can't get out of the elevator. Okay, so headset is still going to sleep on me. Even though I updated the drivers yesterday. You date for over a year. She drives you absolutely nuts. It's great. I don't know if I'd describe being driven nuts as great. You move in, you share an apartment near the school with a view of the mountains. You two drink beers out on the deck. You drink beer just about anywhere. Life is good. It keeps going to sleep. Hopefully the update will stop that happening. Julia wants to get a dog. There's a scruffy, undersized beagle. Julia's in love. She wants to bring it with her to class. It's also intimidating, but gentle-eyed German Shepherd. Nothing bad could happen to Julia while walking this dog. It's badass. You pick up the beagle and she names him Bucket. Or you adopt the German Shepherd and name him Mayhem. Let's go with Beagle. Bucket's a good dog, and a week later you've totally forgotten about the other one. Julia loves him, and you love him too. I'm not going to literally read all the slides. Oh, she asked you about kids. You talk out on the deck. It's summer, 9:30 p.m. and the heat still radiates off the high desert. What do you think about kids, she asks. I'm gonna let personal preference go here. One day, why rush? Huh. She looks away out toward the mountains. We have plenty of time, right? Speak for yourself, mister. Don't worry, you assure her. You tell her she has the body of an undergrad. My ovaries didn't get the memo, she says, laughing it off. One day, okay? 6 months later, you get engaged lying in bed on a Sunday morning. Huh. So if I suddenly drop out audibly, please let me know. Interesting map. Let's see what's here. Do do do. Okay, so clearly the going to sleep issue is not resolved. So let me go back to my podcast mic. Hang on one second. Okay, I've gone back to the Yeti. Let's see what happens. Okay, I'm back on the. Oh, that is so loud. Yeah, when I alt tab out, it it actually sends me out of the game. So I'm using the other headset now. This is really, really annoying because those headset and headset was not cheap. I apparently totally forgot I was using a controller. Yeah, I've got a Yeti for podcasting. What I wanted the headset so I could be wireless because now I'm basically tethered to my desk. Things have gotten dark. There's a festival in town. It brings folks in from very faraway places. One of them tries to mug you with a knife. Bucket gets kicked. I'm gonna beat his face in. Yeah, walk by the river, that's very safe. 1984, plans to have kids get waylaid by work. Julie gets offered a job at Yale. Yale's in Connecticut, 2,000 miles away. It's a great job, associate department chair. She wants to move. You absolutely do not. Wow, this is kind of a dick move to make early in the game. Ooh. She's gonna commute and leave me, 'cause that's gonna get old real quick. In 1985, Julie sent home from Yale on paid leave after having an episode, quote unquote. She lost it on a colleague for borrowing books that were important to her research. She didn't remember she had happily loaned them to him just 2 days prior. She was found crying in the stairwell. Oh, this got dark quick. After seeing multiple doctors and having many tests, they're worried that Julia might be suffering from early onset dementia.
She's 41. You decide to keep it a secret for now. And this got dark really quick. Bucket's getting older. Julia comments that it's kind of nice because he gets in less trouble around the house. A week later, she goes back to the university. Her affliction gets worse. She can't remember things in class. Her research is in shambles. She drives her car to the next town over for no particular reason and has to be brought home by the police. She's devastated. She's sent home on permanent medical leave. Some days you get the Julia who calls you a dope and your unborn children little idiots. Other days you get a stranger. She pulls you into bed to make love. After 5 minutes, she goes into a panic believing her dad is at the door. You tell her family. They are crushed and begin to make trips to and from their home in Australia to visit her. For a while, your friends come by with little things to brighten her day. She gets worse. You spend your days following Julia around the house. You count the seconds between the 2 weekly visits from Daniel the nurse. He suggests that Julia could live somewhere else, somewhere with 24-hour care, a home. It sits with you for a couple of months. Ooh, this is getting kind of deep and... This may get a little personal for me, so if I get upset or cry on the stream, it's not you guys. This is not what I expected out of the game at all. The choices are to move her into a facility or take care of her yourself. I'm gonna go with move her into a facility. This is so not what I actually expected from this game. I don't know why. Her family agrees with the decision. You find a fantastic place in Boulder, move her there. You see her every day. Then every other day. You go out to the bar with your old friends. It's not the same. You get the feeling every wife tells her husband, if you ever put me in a home like Henry did, I'll cut your balls off. You slowly decide not to see your old friends that much. Julia's sister Susan moves to Boulder to be close to her. She visits her every day. You go with her some of the time. Susan buys you an old typewriter and urges you to use it if you won't see a therapist. You won't. You always really like Susan. Months go by. Bucket dies. Julia doesn't remember him when you tell her. Sometimes it takes her a minute to lock in on you. In the back of your mind, you believe it's because you see her less and less. And seeing her less and less makes her forget you more, you think. Summer's coming and you see an ad in the paper for a job. You take it. This is really fucking grim. Steven, can you do me a favor and tweet out that, no, I can't think of what I'd say, but I guess when this goes on YouTube, I'll have a trigger warning that this game is not as, I don't know what I thought. Thank you.
Two Forks Tower.
Said on the phone.
So, what's wrong with you?
Excuse me?
People take this job to get away from something, so what's wrong?
What's wrong with you?
That's a great idea. Go ahead.
Look, I just hiked for 2 days, so I don't really follow whatever it is you're doing right now.
You take a stab at what's wrong with me.
Fine, then can I sleep forever? Stand you, which, after this brief introduction, is not a big shock.
Ouch. I'll chalk that up to you being tired and grumpy.
Well, I better get some sleep then.
One sec. Now it's my turn.
Okay. Good night. Bye.
Let's see. I don't know anything about you, but 9 times out of 10, folks out here simply got dumped.
Wow. Okay. Let me finagle with audio. Well, there wasn't much audio. Give me 1 sec, I'm trying to figure out the audio thing. Well, I'm trying to get to the options. Okay. I'm trying to figure out why escape is not working. I alt-tabbed out. That's not what I wanted. Alright, escape is not giving me... Alright, escape is not giving me options. I have to alt-tab out because there's no full window. Hey, Carson. And there's no audio because I've alt-tabbed out of the game. I just want to know how to get to the options. I literally just want instructions. That's not what I wanted. Okay, I don't know why I can't pull up the menu. Well, the controller's not giving me any options. I should be able to pull up a menu regardless of how I'm playing it.
Ticket?
Easy there, Dirty Harry.
Well?
Get going. You'll probably need a rope to get down the shale between you and the lake, if I remember right. There should be one in the supply box on the way. The code is 1234. It's actually that for all of them.
Secure.
I'm gonna put the damn thing down. Okay, now can I use escape? There we go. Okay, I've cranked up the audio. So the audio and everything else is cranked up, so I'm not sure what else you would like me to do. Subtitles are on, everything else. Just let me save, because I don't know what else is going on. So hopefully that helps. Because right now there's no actual in-game audio while I'm kind of running around. Okay, so trying to find a rope. I'd like to put this down. I'm guessing there's no run mechanic yet. I guess I am going to cache box 306. Hopefully I'm going the right way. I did not see a mini map. No, I am going entirely the wrong way. But I like how the map moves when you move. Okay, hopefully I'm going the right way. Because anyone who's ever watched me play Dragon Age has seen how terrible I am at following a map. Oh, hey. Can't go through that tree. Would be what? Oh, nope, that is the powerhouse. I thought it was an outhouse at first. Hey, Sky. Yeah, this is why I don't go hiking. Okay, at least we're on the right path. In theory. Okay, supposedly I'm headed right toward this box. Not turning, I just thought it was something this way. Little to the right should be the cash box. Aha.
I found the supply box.
So very secure. Let's see what else is in here. Granola bar. Dude, you just picked up this old ass granola bar. You don't even know where it came from. Yep, that's pine cone, all right. What's this? Dang it. I'm gonna read that note. Guy couldn't take it, so I locked up his Outlook and put some stuff in the box. Found one of those bars you like hiking in the park. Okay. Alright, now that I've got this. Okay. As far as I remember, it was out by the medicine wheel. Like, it's a rope and an old ass granola bar. Like, you don't even know how old it is. All right, let's hope we're going the right way. Let's save just in case. Oops, sorry. Yeah, I turned up the master volume for the game. Really hoping I'm actually going the right way, because I grew up in the city. I am like the most useless person to take anywhere on any kind of nature or anything. Like, for real, don't take me anywhere in the woods. Hopefully, I'm going the right way.
This medicine wheel near my tower, where should I go to find the fireworks?
They're to your northwest from there, I think. If you hike north from there, you should find the shale slide I mentioned.
Okay, I cranked it all the way up. I don't know what else to do. Okay, so voice is at 100%. There's not a lot of talking in the game.
Oh, I'm still at that medicine wheel. I'm not sure where to go.
It's okay. There should be a couple of trails that head north from there. Take the one on the left, the westerly one.
Okay, I think I can figure that out.
Okay. I am lost. Okay, I'm gonna go back to the cache and then go to the right. Not sure if that's it, but that's my best guess. In a minute. Because now I'm just annoyed. Of course, now that I'm not in the tower, I can't actually see the fireworks. Okay, Skywise, I'm gonna bite. I need help because I'm lost and annoyed. So from where I'm standing, where should I be headed? Because right now I'm headed back toward the lookout. I know there's a delay, that's why I'm leaving the map up. I thought so. I got distracted by the whole audio thing. So go back to the wheel. Okay. Okay, so I'm at the medicine wheel. Okay. So that's west. Okay. That's a dead end. Hey, Donna. Okay. Okay, so from where I'm standing, that's north, which is back where I was headed. That's not useful at all. All right. Night, Steven. This is where I just was. Anyways. All right. I'm lost and irritated. I went to the west and there was nothing there that I could interact with. I went north. Which is... Okay, I don't know where to go. Oh, can't go that way. Okay. All right, that's the view I was just at. It looks like I might be on the right trail finally. But this is where I was last time, and I basically wind up... Nope, that is not the right way. Are you fucking kidding me? And this is why I don't go hiking. And I've gone in a circle in the wrong way. Okay, this is right back where I fucking was. Now I'm just annoyed. Okay, so I'm on the path, but I can't go anywhere. Find the path, and now I can't get past the weeds. Okay, so... where the hell am I supposed to go? Thank you. Okay, I've been playing this for an hour. I have made very little progress. I just got tagged in a really stupid tweet. So, sorry for the pause. I'm just trying to figure out what to do because I don't know what else to do. Except go back to the tower at this point, and now I'm just getting annoyed. Like, I literally don't know what else to do because I found a path that should take me there. Let me get this rope. I got nothing, because it's probably really simple and staring me in the face, but Okay. I'm going to try to find this one more time, and then I'm going to stop, because I'm getting frustrated, and this is not fun. Which path to the far right? That's the path that I went over, and I can't climb them.
Some tools, I'll add groundskeeping to my ever-increasing list of responsibilities.
Okay, so that looks like the way I need to go, so how am I supposed to get there? And that's going the wrong way. This is getting really, really frustrating. Like, today has not been a good gaming day. I don't know where else to go. I literally don't know where to go at this point. Because I've gone in circles. So I'm going to get back to the tower. Because I don't know how else to figure out where I'm going. If I went through all that and there was a something in the tower before I left, you know how mad I'm gonna be? You know how absolutely bug nut fucking angry I'm gonna go? Because I'm actually getting a headache. Okay, so I did all that. There is nothing in here that I can interact with. Okay, so I went all through the forest. I didn't find the damn path. I don't know which way to go once I'm out there, and the supervisor is less than useful. So I don't know what to do. And I can't open the desk drawer. Can't go to sleep. I don't know what to do. Because I basically went in a circle. I did all of that and went in a circle. And I literally don't know where to go. How was there a walkthrough? The game just came out. Because now I'm just annoyed. I don't know where else to go, because everywhere I've gone... has literally been a dead end, or I've gone in a circle. And it's probably something very simple. Oh my god, who has had time to play it like that? You know what? I'm just gonna stop because I'm getting irritated. I'm getting an actual headache from this. Steven, why don't you link me a Let's Play through Facebook or something? Because I'm going to call it here because I'm getting annoyed. I don't know where to go. And I'm just going to stop before I get really angry and rage quit on stream. Which is what I'm kind of doing anyway. So I'm going to let this go. I'm going to end the stream and try to look up something or come back to it when I'm not tired and clearly annoyed. So I will maybe stream something that will be relaxing later. Otherwise, I will have my usual stream on Thursday, which may be some XCOM. I will talk to you all later.